How's it going? It's Sunday, April 16th. I just got done with about 6 hours of driving. I got one more to go. Stopped and filled up on some gas. Really excited about this weekend. I just keep thinking about it this whole drive home. It was about as picture perfect as it gets. I left work Friday evening, made a 6 hour drive south, ended up getting there around 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning, catching a little bit of sleep. And then I got in really tight onto a bird on the roost on Saturday morning. And it was just a picture perfect hunt. I mean, I could see him strutting with the sunrise in the background, and he ended up being pretty cooperative. Shortly after that, Parker got one. He texted me, and so we decided to go get some food, and then we were gonna head for a piece of national forest about 2 hours away. Ended up roosting some birds Saturday night. Didn't really have much luck on Sunday. I heard a lot of birds, but we kind of battled with some property lines and some kind of steep country. It was definitely a little bit different hunting, but it's really fun breaking down new ground like that. So it was just an all-around great trip, absolutely perfect. It was awesome to meet Parker, get to do some hunting with him. We both got birds. That's obviously a nice bonus. So I hope you enjoy the video. I'm really excited about it. Quick.
I don't know how much of that we got, but here is our current situation. Just a beautiful,
absolutely beautiful
spot for a gobbler. I mean, I came up here the last time I was in this area last weekend. Hardly saw any sign, but figured it was high ground. There was a bird on the other side over there, and I was going up that way, trying to get around the saddle to get on top of them. But whenever I came around to do so, that bird gobbled. I mean, it was still plenty dark, but I got set up right here, and I kind of had this tree in front of me. Actually, he was roosting right there. I kind of had this tree in front of me, but he was facing that way. So I knew I had a good chance of him flying down this direction. And my gun was too long, it was gonna hit on the tree. So I got positioned this way. Figured if he flew down over here, chances are he's gonna be behind that little crest, so I can move on him then. So what I did was I got on him right here, and he flew down kind of behind that tree. I don't know if he was on the backside and I just couldn't see him, or if he was behind brush or what, but when he hit the ground, I called and he gobbled. I heard him drumming, and then I called again. And sure enough, I just slowly see him strutting his way up through here. But from my position, I had this branch right here. I mean, he wasn't all but 30 yards. A week after opening day, in a place that I first stepped foot in last week. Not only did I get one that week, but I did it in even shorter fashion today. I can't believe it. It's not about the kill. That's just the cherry on top. Just getting out here, watching the sun come up. I mean, that bird was backlit, orange sun. Just beautiful. Two hunts this whole year, two birds. I've had that happen one time before, but that was in my home state. And I've been able to scout like a madman beforehand. So to come in here and say, hey, this is where I'm going, and it to work out, another bird just gobbled. I can tell you one thing for sure,
I'm going to Bojangles.